To infinity and beyond!
Since Woody and Buzz flew into our lives nearly 25 years ago, Pixar has added quite a few new characters to Andy's toy box.
New toys!
I'm Dolly.
I'm Trixie.
I'm trying to stay in character.
But to be frank, I think we have to draw the line somewhere.
I am not a toy. I'm a spork.
Forky, I couldn't agree more.
Is that how we look on the inside? There's so much fluff.
Holding on to the number one spot for the second week in a row is Toy Story 4, bringing in an estimated $58 million in its sophomore weekend. As to be expected, Pixar has the perfect formula to break the franchise fatigue moviegoers have been experiencing this summer.
Did you hear what the kids are calling you? Phoenix.
While films like Dark Phoenix and Men in Black International have struggled or outright flopped at the box office, Toy Story 4 is still bringing in the kind of box office dollars Walt Disney is used to. Toy Story 4 had the best domestic opening of the franchise, and after just 2 weekends in theaters, it's made nearly $500 million worldwide. As for what Pixar's box office formula is, well, making a really good movie can't hurt. And with that, on to number two.
How could you not tell me you're babysitting for the Warrens tonight?
And we'll be back early tomorrow morning.
Have fun. Don't your parents keep any creepy stuff around?
We keep it all locked away in a room. It's not good for anyone to go in there.
Taking the number two spot in its debut weekend is Annabelle Comes Home, bringing in an estimated $20 million in its first weekend out. This is the third film in the Annabelle franchise and the sixth film in the Conjuring horror movie universe. Unfortunately, Annabelle Comes Home is having the worst debut of the group. That said, horror movies are almost always a good investment because they are almost always the cheapest films to make. Annabelle Comes Home only cost the folks at Warner Brothers $27 million to produce. And if you combine the domestic debut with the overseas box office dollars, Annabelle Comes Home is well past profitability. Last but not least this week is yet another new box office release. Yesterday brought in a better than expected $17 million in its first weekend out. Not so fun fact, of the top 10 films at the box office right now, Yesterday is the only one that is not a sequel, spinoff, reboot, or biopic. So even though I haven't seen the film, bravo to Universal Pictures for at least that. As for next week, Marvel's world domination continues.
Heads up, Nick Fury's calling you.
I don't really want to talk to Nick
Fury. Answer the phone.
Why?
Because if you don't talk to him, then I have to talk to him. I don't want to talk to him.